Batia Struli, Minister of Marine Affairs and Fisheries, fellow panelists, allow me to start by first congratulating my colleague, Minister Susi Batia Struli, her team, and the entire government of Indonesia for successfully organizing this successful Our Oceans Conference. After the devastating earthquake in Palu, and even in the midst of a plane crash yesterday, please accept Namibia's deepest sympathy for the loss you have suffered as a country. I also take this opportunity to thank the organizers for inviting me to address you at this Global Ocean Leadership Forum. Namibia is a leader on best practices of oceans leadership in Africa, and indeed globally, because of the following reasons. One, Namibia has a right-based fishery, not open access as is the case in many developing countries. Namibia conduct fishery stock assessments annually using our own state-of-the-art research vessel, which helps us to set sustainable total allowable catches on an annual basis for all our commercial species. Thirdly, Namibia has put in place infrastructure and institutional arrangements for monitoring, control, and surveillance to control IUU fishing. This includes patrol planes, patrol boats, and a VMS system, all operated by the Ministry of Fisheries and Marine Resources. In addition, we have a separate Fisheries Observer Agency, another first for Africa, which helps to independently monitor fishing operations by placing observers on board of fishing vessels, hence providing instant counter-checks on fisheries inspectorate services. Because of these deliberate measures, Namibia was able to reverse the collapse, the near-collapse situation in our hake and other fisheries which we inherited at the time of our independence in 1990 to a stable commercial stock currently. Fourthly, we are a signatory to the Port State Measures Agreement because we believe we must fight IUU together as a family of nations, not as a lone ranger. Fifthly, we are members of the high-level panel on sustainable oceans economy led by Norway and Palau, where I'm serving as Namibia's shepherd. Namibia is keen to work together with other 12 countries in this panel to broaden our political support for actions on sustainable economic oceans economies. On the marine protected areas, let me say that Namibia has more than 10% of its EEZ as a protected area. We have made it illegal to fish in areas shallower than 200 meters along our entire coastline of over 1,500 kilometers. This area has not yet been determined and hence not yet gazetted, but that is what we want to do in the very, very near future. We have several conservation areas which have also not been accurately mapped out, even though fishing is legally prohibited in these areas. The two areas together constitute a large area of our EEZ. We have, however, gazetted areas around our 16 maritime islands as MPAs, which is 12,000 6,000 square kilometers. We have made significant progress on the MPA matter, but I acknowledge that a lot still needs to be done. I am confident that once we finalize accounting and gazetting current protected areas as MPAs by 2020, we should already be at the 10% target or more, and we are willing to do even more on this matter. I note that our ocean conference include concrete pledges for action, and Namibia is no exception on this matter. In the next 12 months, Namibia is pledging about $5 million for marine protection and research. This includes $2.7 million additional funds to intensify the fight against IUU and improve ocean governance, and a further $2.3 million to facilitate research on oceans, especially on fishery stocks and marine ecosystems. These funds are in addition to normal budgetary allocations to the ministry for routine activities. I acknowledge that global ocean leadership is more than setting MPAs. It involves providing human, financial, and infrastructure resources to enforce conditions of MPAs, the political and legal will to combat IUU fishing, fish crime, including money laundering, transfer pricing, and other illegal ocean activities such as drugs and human trafficking. You may be wondering why does a developing country with only about 500,000 metric tons fishery standings annually, valued at $600 million, spend almost 90% of our $35 million of its fisheries revenue on ocean research, management, and governance issues? Well, to begin with, sustainable utilizing and protecting our oceans is expressly included in our constitution, the supreme law of our land. This is one of the few constitutions in the world which have this provision. Before the term blue economy was coined, Namibia understood well that our future depends on oceans, hence we must protect it for the present as well as future generations. We are happy to join the family of nations committed to protect our oceans. We can only do this effectively if we do it together, and I thank you for your attention.